Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss some new topics related to the electricity. So firstly, we'll recall our previous topics. In the previous lecture, we studied about the topics electric current and the potential difference. So what is electric current? The rate of flow of electric charges is defined as the electric current, and electric current is measured in the ampere by the ampere unit, and it is formulated by I equals to Q upon T, that is the rate of flow of charges. Similarly, we are having the potential and the potential difference. Potential is defined as when we bring in a unit positive charge from the infinity to a certain point, the amount of work done to bring that charge from infinity to a particular point is defined as the potential. And when we transfer that particular charge from one point to another point, that will be the potential difference between those two points. So potential, mathematically potential is defined as the V equals to W upon Q, that is work done per unit charge. It is measured in the volt, that will be equals to the 1 joule per coulomb. Yeah? So these are our previous topic. Now today we are going to discuss the new topics, in which very first we are having symbols of the commonly used components, and secondly we are having Ohm's law, third we are having some factors that affects the resistance of the circuit, and next we are having some numericals related to the topic. So firstly we will go through the symbols. We are having the table in our NCERT book in which we are having symbols of the commonly used components. So very first we will go through the table. So here we are having the table, that will be on one side we are having the components and one side we are having the symbols. So in our board exams, sometimes you are having one mark question from this particular table, that is draw the electric circuit, draw the circuit diagram of the battery, draw the wire crossing without join, draw the circuit diagram or the symbol of the electric bulb. So we are having various question, various 1 marks question from this table. So you just, all of you, go through the table. So I'll just summarize the table. What we are having in the table? A electrical cell is defined by the two parallel lines in which one line is the greater than the other. Greater line defined as the positive terminal of the cell, and the smaller line defined as the negative terminal of the cell. This symbol is commonly used for the one cell. Then if you are having the combination of the cell, that means if you are having 1, 2 cell, 3 cell, then we are just keep on connecting the number of cells in the series order. That means in which we are having, very first, if you are having the first cell, that is, this will be the positive terminal of the cell and this will be the negative terminal of the cell. Then if you want to connect the another cell with the previous cell, then what will we do? We'll connect the positive terminal of the second cell to the negative terminal of the first cell. And similarly, we will keep on adding the number of the cell which we want to add. Now we are having the next component, that will be the plug key or the switch. If we want to open the plug key, so that is the symbol for the open plug key. And this next will be the symbol of the closed plug key. After that, we are having a wire joint. That means number of wire we are jointing at the same point. So this will be the symbol of the wire joint at the same point. After that, we are having the wires without joint. If we are having two wires and we will two wire crossing without joint, then we are having this symbol of the wire crossing without the join. After that, we are having electrical bulb. So as we know, we are having in our previous classes also the symbol of the bulb. That will be the symbol of the bulb. After we are having the resistance, we will study about the resistance in our next topic. Then we are having the variable resistance. Now we are not having the concept of the variable resistance in our class 10. That will be the concept of the class 10. Then after that, we are having two important phenomena that we have already studied about, the ammeter and the voltmeter. These two are the symbol of the ammeter and the voltmeter. The only difference is in the ammeter symbol, we are having A here. A is written over here. And so we can identify the ammeter in our laboratories. Similarly, if you are having the voltmeter symbol, So this will be the voltmeter symbol. So V will be written over here, and we are having positive and the negative terminal for the both. And this will be the positive and this will be the negative. So this is our very important, basically we can say table in which we are having very important circuit symbols. So you just, all of you, go through the table and just find out the circuit symbols of the different components. After that, we are having, now we'll move to our next topic, that will be the Ohm's law. So before starting the Ohm's law, in our NCERT book, we are having one activity. Basically, what is Ohm's law? Ohm's is a scientist, German scientist, which gives us the relationship between, basically, we are studying what topic we have studied, that is the electric current and the potential difference. So Ohm's gives us the relation, and basically many of the scientists do the many of the experiment to find out the relationship between the current and the potential difference. So we are having one activity in our NCERT book also. I already shared the link of the NCERT book. So we are having the activity number 12.1. So you just, all of you, go through the activity. I just only summarize the activity over here. So in the summary, we are having the simple circuit in which we are having one voltmeter, one source. Source we are using as a source, and we are having one key. This will be the simple circuit. And when we, firstly, if we use one cell as a source in the circuit, then we will find out what will be the reading of the voltmeter and the ammeter. Now, this will be our first system. Then secondly, what will we do? We'll add one more cell or the source in the circuit. Now we are having the two sources, or we can say cell in the circuit. Now we will check, we will close the circuit, and then we will check what will be the variation of the voltmeter, the reading of the voltmeter and the reading of the ammeter. Then after that, we'll add one more cell or the source. Then now we are having the three cells in our basically electrical circuit. Then we will check out our readings of the voltmeter and the ammeter. Then with the help of these three or to the four observation, we will draw a table between the V and the I. And after that, we are having a table V, the values of the voltmeter, then values of the ammeter, what we are having the values of the ammeter. After that, we are having the ratio of the V and the I. Then with the help of the table, when we draw the the graph between the current and the voltmeter, current and the potential, then we find out that there will be a straight line between the graph between voltmeter and the ammeter. Now with the help of this activity, we can understand the relationship between, whenever we are having any of the straight line graph between any of the two quantities, then what it means, it means that they are having a proportional relation, they are having the proportional relation. Then finally, Ohm's concluded the different of the experiment, and with the help of the different activities, he finally concluded that the relationship between potential difference and the current. So what he concluded in Ohm's law, he concluded that at the constant temperature, current flowing any of the conductor, we can use any of the conducting wire as the conductor in our electrical circuit. Current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference, applied between the ends of the conductor. That means whatever amount the current is flowing through the conductor, there will be the same variation in the value of the potential difference across the ends of the conductor. So finally, when he concluded the activity, this is the process at the constant temperature. We are having some condition, a physical condition of the constant temperature at which the values, there will be no difference, variation in the different values of the current and the voltage. So at the constant temperature, we will follow the activity, and finally we concluded that current flowing through the conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference applied between the ends of the conductor. And finally, if we just write down the mathematically, so we can write down I is proportional to V. I is proportional to V. That means current flowing through the conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference applied across the ends of the conductor. Now, if we just solve this relation, if we want to remove the proportionality sign, so as by the law, we know that we have to multiply the constant to the right side. Then, so I equals to the constant into the V. After that, whenever we are having the constant at the right side, so we will add a constant 1 upon R. 1 upon R. Just see the point I equals to 1 upon R into V. And finally, if we just conclude that formula, so we can write down V will be equals to I into R. So what is the significance of the R here? So R is basically defined as the constant of proportionality. That means R is a constant for a given metallic wire. That means whatever conductor we are having, we are using in our electrical circuit. So R is constant for that metallic wire. And it is also known as, it is also termed as the basically resistance. It is also termed as the resistance we are having here. It is also called as the resistance. Then, so what is now the resistance? Basically, resistance is the property of the conductor to resist the flow of the current through it. Resistance, what is resistance? Resistance is a property of the, this is the physical significance of the resistance. What is the resistance? If you just want to explain the resistance, resistance is the property of the conductor to resist the flow of the current. And if we just want to calculate the mathematical value of the resistance, so we can have the formula of equals to V equals to I into R. So by the formula, we can find out the value of the R. That means by the ratio of the potential to the current, we can calculate the value of the resistance of any of the metallic wire or any of the conductor. Then, so this is our concept of the Ohm's law. So by the concept of the Ohm's law, we are having a new term, that is the resistance. That is the resistance. So what is resistance? Resistance is the property of the conductor to resist the flow of the current through it. That means whatever there will be the obstruction, the amount of the obstruction in the flow of the current through the conductor, we will find out that amount of the obstruction, that amount of the resistance with the help of the term resistance. Yeah? So, and if you want to measure, if you want to measure the resistance of the any resistance in any of the conductor, how much there will be the obstruction, how much will be the resist, there will be the opposition to flow in the current, then we can find out the value of the resistance with the help of the R. And R can be calculated by the V upon I. That means by the value of the potential and by the value of the current, we can calculate the value of the R. Now we'll talk about the SI unit of the resistance. SI unit of the resistance is defined as R will be equals to the, we already know that the what are the units of the voltage and the current. So voltage is measured in the volt and current is measured in the ampere. So we can write down 1 volt upon 1 ampere equals to the 1 ohm. 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 And it is symbolized by the given sign that is written over here. Now, this is the Greek symbol, the symbol of the ohm. So, we are having SI unit of the resistance is ohm. If you want to just explain what is 1 ohm resistance. So, we can just find, we can just go through the definition of the 1 ohm resistance. 1 ohm resistance of the conductor is defined as the potential difference across the two ends of the conductor is 1 volt. That means if you are having the potential difference of the between the two ends of the conductor is 1 volt and 1 ampere is current flowing through the conductor, then there will be the resistance of the 1 ohm of the conductor. Now, this is the definition of the 1 ohm. Sometimes we are having this definition in our board exams also. So you just see that definition of the very, you just take the definition as the important part of the topic. Now, Now we are having the we are already talked about the resistance of the conductor, resistance of the metallic wire, what we are having, but there are the some factor on which the resistance of the conductor or any of the wire what we are having as a conductor depends. There are the some values on which the resistance of the conductor depends. So we are talking about very first factor we are having here, the length of the conductor. So as we know that we are having the solids, and in the solids we are having free electrons as the free electrons. By the free electron, there will be the flow of the free electrons, and by which the rate by the flow of the free electrons, the electricity will, the current will flow through the conductor. Then, so by in our chemistry classes, we are already having in the previous classes, we are already having the configuration, electronic configuration of the different metals. That means if we are talking about the sodium, so sodium we are having one electron in our last shell, that is in the, that is defined also as the valence shell. So that particular one electron is loosely attached to the parent atom. So that particular free electron is free to move through the molecule, we can say. Then so we are talking about the factors. Now here what will happen? So when free electron will move through the conductor, so there will be the flow of the electric current. Now with the help of the time, we can calculate the amount of the flow of the current. Now so very first we'll talk about what will be the effect on the resistance to the length of the wire. That means if we increase or decrease the length of the wire, then what will be the effect on the resistance of the conductor. So if we'll talk about the resistance length, so length of the conductor, so R, resistance is directly proportional to the length of the conductor. So that means if we increase the length of the conductor, so resistance will also increase. Resistance means it will more resist the flow of the electric current. So we are having here the two diagram. If we are having in the very first diagram, we are having the conductor of this length. So electron, whatever free electron, number of free electrons we are having in the particular conductor, so there will be this space we are having the to move the free electron. But if we increase the length of the wire, so there will be much more atoms are there, and there will be much more obstruction in the flow of the electric free electron. So if we increase the length of the conductor, so there will be the number of, there will be so many obstructions, say there will be so many collision of the free electrons with the other atoms. So that's why if we increase the length of the conductor, so there will be the resistance of the conductor will also increase. Second, we are having the cross-sectional area of the conductor. Then what will happen if we increase the cross-sectional area of the conductor? So cross-sectional area of the conductor is inversely proportional to the resistance of the conductor. That means R is proportional to 1 upon A. So what will happen if we increase? So here we are having also having the two diagrams. In very first diagram, we are having this this much of the cross-sectional area. In the second diagram, we are having this much of the cross-sectional area. So what is the difference between these two diagrams? In very first diagram, we are having the lesser area. Lesser area, that means there will be the number of collision. There are the number of more collisions in that particular area of the cross-sectional area. But when we increase the cross-sectional area, so free electron will get more space to move. That means the number of collision will decrease, and it will get the more space to move from one point to the another point. That means there will be the, that particular cross-sectional area will decrease, increase in the cross-sectional area will decrease in the resistance, decrease in the obstruction in the path of the free electrons. If obstruction will decrease, there will be the more flow of the current. That's why if we increase the area, cross-sectional area of the conductor, so there will be decrease in the resistance of the conductor. Then thirdly, we are having nature of the material of the conductor. So that is the basically the theoretical factor, what material we are having, that resistance of the conductor will also depend on the what type of material, what is the nature of the material of the conductor. Now fourthly, we are having the temperature of the conductor. So if we increase the temperature of the conductor, so what will happen? There will be the number of collisions will also increase. So that will increase the resistance also. Then, so if we increase the temperature, so resistance will also increase. Now, last two factors are the theoretical factors. So we are not having any mathematical formulation for that, but initial two factors we are having the mathematical form, that is R is proportional to L and R is inversely proportional to A. R is inversely proportional to A. So with the help of these two equations, how can we write down these equations? R is proportional to L into 1 upon A. R is proportional to, because both the right hand side are directly proportional to the resistance of the conductor. So we can combine the both the equations. So we are having here R is proportional to L into 1 upon A. After that, if we just remove this proportionality sign, so what we are having? So we will multiply a constant to the right side. So R equals to rho. We are having here rho specific. Rho is the specific resistance. Rho is a constant, proportionality of the constant, and it is also termed as the specific resistance. So R equals to capital R is the resistance of the conductor, equals to the rho into L upon A. So if we calculate here, we are having the new term here, that will be the rho. So rho can be written as R into A upon L. So we will cross multiply the equation and you will get the formula of the rho, that will be equals to the R A upon L. Now rho, I already mentioned that rho is a constant of proportionality, and it is also called the electrical resistivity of the material of the conductor. It is also termed as the electrical resistivity of the material of the conductor. Then, or it is also defined as the specific resistance. Now, if we calculate the SI unit of the rho or the electrical resistivity. So, electrical resistivity, if we calculate the SI unit, so rho, the formula of the rho will be equals to the R into A upon N. So, as we know that for the R, we are having 1 ohm as the unit. For the area, cross-sectional area, we are having meter square upon, for the length, we are having meter. So when we solve this equation, so we will get rho equals to 1 ohm meter. 1 ohm meter is the unit. 1 ohm meter is the unit of the specific resistance. That means, basically, we can say rho is the characteristic property of the material. This is the characteristic property of the material. That means per unit length, what will be the value of the resistance, that will be measured by the specific resistance of the conductor. Then after that, we are having metals and the alloys, and we are having the insulators. So metals and alloys having the low resistivity, where insulators having the high resistivity. Because of the high resistivity in the insulators, there will be much more obstruction in the flow of the electric current. So that in by this region, there will be not easy in the insulator, that is not easy to flow of the electric current, and insulators are not conduct the electricity. So if we just draw the table, so into insulators will having the high resistivity. After that, we are having the very low resistivity. After that, we are having alloys, and after that, we are having the metals. Then, so this is the topic. After that, we are having some application that will be the based on the basically the concept of the electricity. So we'll talk about the application of the electric resistivity in our next class. After that, we are having some numericals that are based on the, we studied about the two formula. One is the Ohm's law. According to the Ohm's law, that will be equals to the V equals to I into R. And after that, we are having the second formula, that is for the electrical resistivity, that is rho equals to RA into RA upon L. So we are having numericals, some numerical based on the basically these two particular formulas. So very first numerical, we are having resistance of an electric iron is 50 ohm. 4.2 ampere current flows through the resistance. Find the voltage between the two points. So we have to calculate the voltage. That means we have to calculate the value of the V here. And what are the given values over here? One, 50 ohm. 50 ohm is the resistance. So we will write down here, given values are R equals to 50 ohm. I equals to, and the amount of the current flowing, that will be equals to the 4.2 ampere. So we have to calculate V. So by the formula, we are having the formula V equals to I into R. So I hope you can place the values in the equation and you will get the answer of the numerical. So you will do it yourself, that the calculation of the question numerical. After that, secondly, we are having a wire of the length 3 meter and the area of the cross section 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square has a resistance of the 3 into 10 to the power minus 2 ohm. Calculate the resistivity of the wire. Now we have to calculate the resistivity of the wire. So resistivity is symbolized by the rho. So that means we have to calculate the value of the rho here. So rho, we have to calculate the rho. What are the given values in the equation? So as length is the given value, that is equal to the 3 meter. After that, we are having the electrical. After that, we are having the cross-section area. That will be equal to the 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square. After that, we are having the resistance, the value of the resistance. That will be equal to the 3 into 10 to the power minus 2 ohm. So by the formula, as we know that in the previous formulation, we are having the formula to calculate the electrical resistivity. That will be equal to the rho equals to Ra upon N. Now we can place all the values in the equation and you will get your answer. And answer is already written over here. You can you will do the calculation of the equation question to yourself. And we are having the answer 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meter. The one more important thing is here, whenever we are having the some that numerical, those are based on the formula of the electrical resistivity. That means sometimes we are not having the value of the cross-sectional area in the given equation. So what we have to do, if the value of the area of the cross-section is not given in any of the question, in that particular case the value of the radius of the wire is given to you. So as we know that, all we know that the basically the shape of the wire is circular in shape. So with the help of the radius of the wire, we can calculate the cross-sectional area of the wire or whatever conductor we are using. We can find out the area of that particular shape of the conductor. So if you are having the wire, so simply we are having the cross-sectional area of the wire will be equal to the pi r square. That means if in the question value of the radius is given to you, then you can calculate the value of the A from here. After that, we are having some worksheet that is based on the topic covered, and we are having some important exemplar problems. So I already mentioned the example number, that means you have to do in your worksheet. So this that's all for today. Thank you.